Hey guys, it's Chase
and Erin
from the Castle Couple, and today we are doing the Flower and Garden Festival here at Epcot 2021. So far we've just taken some pictures of the Mickey Topiary from Fantasia up front, and now we're gonna go look at the pins, some of the merchandise, and you can follow us along through our day also on our Instagram
at the Castle Couple.
So hopefully we'll get some good food, good drinks. They have the violet lemonades back this year, so we're gonna try that. We didn't try it last time. So yeah.
Hey guys, so we did a little bit of shopping.
A little bit is an understatement.
We'll show everything that we got at the end of the video, but we wanted to show you our scavenger hunts now. So we each got a Spikes Pollination Nation Exploration.
It's a lot of Asians.
Scavenger hunt. And the prizes are plates, and I think we each know which plate set we want. You get two plates, and it's a $7.99 map without the discount. We did have a pass holder discount on it.
I think it was like $6.49 with the pass holder discount.
So it's like a dollar less, you know. But we're gonna go around and find all the stuff and complete our maps, and then we'll show you the plates when we get them. But which plates do you want?
I think I'm gonna get the Figment plates because I'm sporting the Figment attire today.
If you didn't guess that, I'm kind of upset with you.
Socks. I'm adding to the collection.
And then I think I'm gonna get the orange one.
It's Festival of the Rose.
It makes sense. So, we'll see you guys in a little bit. So, we just went and got the avocado toast from
Sunshine Griddle.
Sunshine Griddle.
Yes.
So, the avocado toast is really good. It had like avocado on it with goat cheese and tomatoes. And then it had like some edible flowers and stuff on it, which Chase ate the flowers off my toast.
They were good. They were crunchy. They were a little like lettuce or like cabbage. It's alright.
I really liked the avocado toast. It had like a nice flavor. Like they put seasoning in the avocado. I don't know what it is, but it was good.
And it was like a good size too.
The goat cheese made it like creamy, so it was like nice to eat, and it was like really cool because it's kind of hot out today.
Just a wee bit.
It's like 80s.
Yeah, 80s, like mid 80s.
So I really liked it. Chase thought it was okay, but he doesn't like avocados. So
yeah, not a big fan of avocado.
Can't really listen to him on that one.
Sorry.
But I really liked it.
Tropical plants may be as important as the bananas growing on both sides of the bowl. More than 28 million tons of bananas are eaten annually, making it the most popular fruit in the world. Familiar with the handful that make up our everyday diet, the common grains growing here, wheat, maize, sorghum, and millet, plus rice, account for nearly two-thirds of our global food consumption. Learning how to increase yields of these staples is an important goal of research around the world. With it, we can produce over 27,000 heads of lettuce a year in this one small area.
Alright, so we just got done doing the butterfly garden and Nemo. Of course, Nemo is one of our must-dos when we come to Epcot. Butterfly garden was good. There were lots of... There were lots and lots of butterflies.
Oh my god, yeah.
So, we saw a couple escape, but yeah, it's presented by Go-Go's Bees. I don't like Go-Go's Bees. Aaron does. So we also saw some of the topiaries. There is a Figment topiary this year, and I am super excited for it. I am here for it, and I love it. So now we are going to go over and maybe try just a few of the booths, and then try some more later. Anything else you want to add? We pin traded a little bit. We might include like the pins that we traded in like a little clip at the end, maybe. So yeah.
So we just went to Flavorful Kitchen and we each got something. So I got the cookie butter worms and dirt drink. We don't really know what it is, so we got it. And Chase is nervous for it.
Yeah, it makes me anxious.
And then
I got the strawberry mousse with chocolate pearls, I think is what it was called. It's like a dessert. With the strawberry. So yeah, we're gonna eat these and let you guys know how it goes.
So our experience there was a little interesting. My drink was good, but I really don't know what the flavor was.
Yeah, I had a little bit of it. It was like, you know, it tasted almost like coffee. Like
it was coffee-ish, but not like
not too yeah.
Coffee. I don't know. It was good though. I drank the whole thing.
And it was cold.
Cookies on top, and there were worms on the bottom. I wasn't getting where the worms were coming from. But I found them at the bottom.
The gummy worms were good.
Yeah, that was my drink, and then...
My strawberry, I mean, you can obviously see, it was not great. I didn't taste a lot of strawberry in it, to be totally honest. I mean, not my favorite. I think it came with, like, a real, like, a true strawberry. And that was good. I mixed, like, the strawberry with the chocolate, like, ground up cookies, basically, the Oreo cookies. And then a bite of it, and it was pretty good, but they only gave you like one strawberry, kind of the three slices, so it was like, unless you were gonna finish it in three bites, maybe it would have been okay. Honestly, between like this one, the gummy worms were probably like the best part, which sounds so terrible. As a 21-year-old would be like, gummy worms are the best part, but the gummy worms are the best part. I don't know that I would, I have chocolate all over my hands. I don't know if I would recommend getting that. I mean, the cookie thing was good if you're like looking, if you like savory drinks, I guess. I don't know.
Interesting.
It was just interesting. So we're gonna walk through the Healthful Trail now, try to find our next Spike the Bee for our scavenger hunt. And then I think we may walk around and just see what some of the other booths have, see if we can get something else, because I'm a little hungry. I don't know about you, but I'm a little hungry. So yeah. Think so, not the frozen one.
I don't know. It's normal.
That's like the frozen dessert one, and then I got the violet lemonade ale. I'm gonna try and see how it is. Everybody raves about the violet lemonade, so I figured I'd try the ale and see how it is.
So my drink is good. It's like very sweet, I guess.
Reminds me of like a Starbucks refresher.
And like I guess it's, I don't know, it's good though. And it's like a slushy kind of. It's like melting. It's hot out.
I like slushies.
So it's kind of melting, but it was a slushie when we got it, so. Yeah, and then,
I think it's like Playa Linda is the brewing company, I think. It's really good. It's very, like Aaron was saying, it's kind of citrusy. It's kind of tart. I'm kind of new to the whole drinking thing in beer. So it's kind of tart. Yeah, no, I definitely get it again, though. It's really nice. So it's cool, refreshing. So this festival I thought was different because I think this is the first festival they're doing it at where it's like two different sizes. So I got the smaller size, the 6-ounce size, and that one was $4.50, and then they have a 12-ounce size for $8.50. So we just finished with the beef tenderloin tips. It was awesome. That's probably going to be one of my favorites. It was like hearty. Like, that was a good way to put it. It was hearty and like...
The mashed potatoes were really good.
Mashed potatoes were delicious. Like, if that was anything like Le Cellier, which hopefully maybe sometime sooner rather than later we'll end up going there, but reservations, we looked like 180 days out and they're still not in. So hopefully we might sneak a reservation or sneak a waitlist sometime.
Eventually.
This year, maybe. This year. But... super good, super tender. I'm really picky about how my steak is cooked, and it was perfect for me.
It was really good.
Yeah, so overall really good. We're gonna keep going around the world and see
what
other goodies we can find. Alright, so we are at the, I'm not even going to try to pronounce that, the Japan booth, and I got Fushi, which, so that's definitely the cantaloupe one. That's
they all
pineapple.
Have each of them in it, baby.
Oh, really? Oh,
yeah,
they do.
Wow.
Well, there's three of them, so we'll let you guys know how it is. They look good. So we just finished with the Fushi. It was really, really good. So it came with three pieces, and Aaron had one, I had two. It was really good. I like fruit. If you're a fan of like the fruit that comes in, it's like pineapple, cantaloupe.
Strawberry.
Strawberry, that's what it was. Then it came with like, I don't know if it's like raspberry or maybe more strawberry. It might be raspberry. Like a raspberry drizzle on it. I didn't have any of the whipped cream with it, but it was definitely good. So we just got the beef tenderloin tips from the Northern Blossom booth. It looks really good. It's like one of our favorites for all the festivals. So we'll let you guys know how it is.
Today
we got a whole bunch of food.
Yeah.
We got a whole bunch of merchandise. We got our plates. We finished our scavenger hunt. I got Figment, of course.
Decided on orange root.
Yeah,
I think it's upside down.
It's upside down. That's fine.
Now he's right side up.
So yeah. So we rode a couple rides. We rode Frozen. Anything else to add? I mean, festival was good overall.
We went on Living with the Land.
Living with the Land was cute. I liked that a lot. I don't think we did an outro from Living with the Land.
No, we didn't intro it either.
No.
We went on Living with the Land. You probably saw that already, but.
So yeah,
that.
So I think now we might park hop over to Magic Kingdom.
For the rest of the night,
just
yeah.
Check out, see what's there. So don't forget to like and subscribe. Comment below what you want to see on the channel as far as videos go.
We need ideas.
Yes.
Help.
So thanks.
Thanks in advance.
So now I think that's going to be all for us. And we'll see you guys around the kingdom.
Bye.